We're live at Husky Stadium, located here in Seattle, where these fans are going crazy as these teams take the field. This coin toss presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. McGrath is on the field to kick this one off, and everyone in the stadium is ready for this game to get started. Davis fields it at the three. Tackle at the 33-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Scrambling around. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. And he dives forward. Well, they didn't get the first down, but it was still a pretty good run by the quarterback.
He made a good decision to take off there.
Run left side. Gets to about the 44-yard line. The running back goes for a short gain, but it's enough to get the first down.
Well, the defense did a pretty good job there and didn't give him much room. Unfortunately for them, it was just enough space to eke out 2 yards he needed for the first down.
That's a gain of 8 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 2.
He's taken down right around the 40.
When you're running the ball for big chunks of yards like that, you've got something working.
Just throws this one away. From the 40-yard line, it's 2nd down. Ahmed gets it on the inside. They'll bring him down around the 38-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
That's a great tackle at the 17-yard line.
Well, that's a big-time play there. And as a quarterback, you're willing to take certain chances with certain wide receivers. You're not going to put the ball into coverage like that very often. If you have confidence and trust, and you've worked out a lot with that wide receiver, you know what his abilities are, and you know that you have confidence that he's going to be able to come down, regardless of putting it up in traffic, you're willing to take that chance. And that time is exactly what we saw.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. He fights forward to about the 16.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. Tight back. 3rd down.
Here we go. Easy. Eagle.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
It's up, and it's through the uprights. Henry has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Davis from the 8. He's out to the 30. Tackle made at the 32-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Carries the ball for a nice game. Flags are down, and this one might be on the offense.
Holding offense.
These are the calls that drive still a coach crazy. Senseless penalties can sometimes be the difference between winning and losing the game.
From their own 22-yard line, it's 1st down.
That'll make it 2nd and long.
Fires complete over the middle. Tackle
at about the 33-yard line.
Five wide. Slings it. He has some room. To the 20. To the 10. Shows some moves and he's in. The halfback got his number called on the pass play and came through with a score.
Well, this is what separates good backs from great ones. You have to have the ability to contribute to the passing game.
It makes for an easy completion when you've got a guy who's that wide open. He splits the uprights with the extra point.
With a three-play, 68-yard drive, and they get it in for seven.
The score now, 7-3. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. He's out to the 30. He's tackled at the 30.
Returns the kick. Kickoff returns 25 yards.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan.
And they make the stop at the 28.
I'll give the defense all the credit here. They had that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
That'll bring up second and 12.
From their own 28-yard line, second down.
Mike 10.
Watch the screen.
Ready.
Quick throw, incomplete. One of his receiver.
The ball just sailed on him, and he knows it. He'll get it next time.
That brings up third and 12.
They come out on an empty backfield. Throws and it's incomplete. So they couldn't pick up the long yardage and now they'll have to punt.
It was a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line.
You know what? It might not have been a lot, but they moved the ball forward. Football's not a game won 100 yards at a time. You take what you can get.
This offense just torched the defense through the air with a great passing attack on their last drive.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying off.
4 yards on that play.
He took what the defense gave him that time, which is okay. It keeps the yards to go a little bit more manageable.
Strike to his receiver, no good. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 47. USC holds a four-point lead. He throws right. So that'll make it fourth down.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
Make it fourth and six.
Taken down at the 29.
The Trojans are smothering the opposition so far today. What's this offense got to do to get off the schneid?
Well, you talk to offensive coordinators about that, and they'll say we've got to find our go-to guy. Who are our players that we know we can count on, and what are the plays that we typically feel the most confident about? That's usually where the offenses tend to go when they're getting shut down like this.
Tackle made at the 41. He's taken down at the 42-yard line.
That's a gain of one on the play. That brings up second and 9.
Brought down at about the 43-yard line.
Fuller, the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up third and 8.
Swings it out there incomplete. And they're going to have to bring on the punt team.
On third down, the defense was expecting the pass. And they defended the play very well in the secondary.
And he didn't get anything on that return.
Well, the coverage team did an outstanding job at containing here. You always see this with this team. They're very disciplined on special teams.
USC is up by four. And he's tackled around the 32-yard line. Almost intercepted.
Number 21.
It's third and seven. Ball on their own 32. Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete. Both offenses trying to find their rhythm in that first quarter. Low scoring and close right now. USC's up by four. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. The punting team's got to give their kickers some time. It's a short kick.
21-yard punt. Out of bounds at the 47-yard line.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Ahmed picks up about 7 yards on the run.
That'll bring up second and three.
Regular.
Handoff, and he's met in the backfield.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want none of this.
That'll bring up third and four.
Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun.
Ready. Easy. Lock in.
Throws it out, and it falls incomplete.
Number 26, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it fourth and four.
The punter is going to try to pin him deep in their own territory with a good punt here. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. USC is up four. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
Here's a counter play. He's tackled around the 26-yard line. This one out to the left. That's going to bring up fourth down.
The offense really had nowhere to go on that one. The play was very well defended, and now the incompletion will force the fourth down and a punt.
And he's taken down at the 48. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That's good for a game of 7 yards. That makes it second and two.
Pass out to the tight end, but it's incomplete.
Receiver on the play.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks.
Tight end right. Four down.
They've got Mike T right here, guys. Mike
T. He gets sacked on the play.
Loss of 8 yards on the play. That brings up fourth and 11.
He'll try to knock this punt down inside the 20. From the 15, he gets out to about the 28-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. USC holds a four-point lead. He's scrambling. They'll make the sack.
He has one job on passing situations. Get to the quarterback. And he did that job very, very well on that play.
From their own 26-yard line. Second down.
Ready.
He steps out right around the 28-yard line. It out. Picked off by the senior. And down he goes at the 41-yard line. And that was just an outstanding pick.
Great play by the defender to high point the ball, but the quarterback wasn't in rhythm on the throw.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 41. Quick throw. He's taken down around the 39-yard line.
Number 15 on the tackle at the 39-yard line.
Right.
That makes it second and 8.
Good open field tackle and a nice pickup there.
I'll tell you what, the defense gambled a bit here and came with the blitz, and a quarterback showed tremendous poise by making a good read and delivered a nice ball to the open man.
Sack.
Brad, not only did they give up a sack here, but their quarterback just got hit and hit hard. If I'm an offensive coordinator, especially an offensive line coach, I'm getting a hold of my offensive line, making sure these guys are on the same page, and they've got to take more pride in taking care of their quarterback than that play right there.
So the sack makes this a second and long. He throws left. Incomplete pass.
That pass didn't look exactly right when it left his hand. Sometimes you don't get a great grip on the ball and it comes out a little wobbly.
Caught over the middle. They'll bring him down right around the 18-yard line.
I know the defense would have liked to have prevented such a big game, but the important thing is that they held and brought up fourth down.
They'll line it up for the field goal. The kick is up, and it is good. Henry looks ready to kick this one off. Fielded at the 9. Whoa, he just took a licking. Right now, this game's got all the makings of maybe being a nail biter.
Yeah, this game just feels like it's going to go well into the second half, probably into the fourth quarter. You almost have a feel that maybe one of the defenses may have to score a touchdown to be able to win this game.
Their last drive ended with an interception. We're about to find out what the defense can do this time.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in. It's second and 10. Ball on the 31. USC up a point.
Green and Yank! Green and Yank!
USC is going to use their first time out of the half here. Nice pass there, and the quarterback was under a lot of pressure from the defense.
Good decision here. Nice dump off. It's only 7 yards, but the offense will take that play every time.
He's got it with room to run. Tackle right around midfield.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
There's a strike complete. And they make the stop at about the 13.
First down.
Pressure got to him, and he put it on the ground. The offense scoops it up, and they'll get him in the backfield. Low-scoring first half of play, but a close game. 7-6, USC.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
What a terrific first half. This is everything we anticipated this game being, and we're going to be riveted to this game, I feel like, David, in the second half, anticipating a terrific finish.
It's fun. It's living up to the hype every single time. We can't even turn the channel here. We got it on the big screen, on the big 60-inch. Yes, it's quite nice, by the way, too. The weather's nice and warm. It's beautiful. Got some chips. We're opening them up a little bit, but great game, living up to the hype. It definitely feels like both teams are evenly matched. It feels like it can go either way. It feels like it's going to come down to the wire. And the only thing I hope it doesn't come down to is a kicker. Please don't come down to a kick in the end. Both these teams playing great D, playing great O, you know, physical, you know, pounding on each other, making big plays. Don't come down to a finesse kick by like a soccer player, please.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. It's going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 29-yard line. 23 yards. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. The Trojans saw one of their top players go down earlier, but it looks like he's going to be able to get back in there. USC with a one-point lead. And he hits him hard at the 37-yard line.
Gain of 8 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 2.
It's 2nd down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. And he just gets rid of it. The Trojans had one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to return.
Set, right,
Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. And that'll make it 4th down.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on the pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. He's got the corner. He makes it out to midfield.
You know, this offense is doing a pretty good job moving the football. The problem is they're not coming up with touchdowns. The offensive coordinator who's been up here next to us, Brad, the booth next to us, he's actually just taken off his headsets, and I think he's going down to the field to be next to the quarterback and the rest of this offense to try to engage with them to realize how important it is to finish these drives.
He's at the 40. Gains his way to the 39-yard line. Throws right away. Oh boy, almost intercepted. They're really fortunate that wasn't intercepted.
Not a very smart decision by the quarterback. He had no shot at completing it.
2nd and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line. And he throws it away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
He lets it fly. Can't connect.
You definitely want to give your receiver some room to run under the ball. Not that much.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. He's going to air it long. Almost intercepted. And they're going to have to give the ball back after going for it on fourth and long.
Not much you can do there. You got to go for it and give yourselves a chance.
Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. USC is up one. Swings it out left to the halfback. And they push him out at the 47-yard line.
That's a gain of 8 on the play. That makes it second and 2.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 22-yard line.
Called a gain of 31 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver.
Number 6, the intended receiver on the play.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 22-yard line. Grabs it and hammered right there.
That's a gain of 1 on the play.
Gotta move quick. Gotta move quick right here.
Deep ball, laying it out there.
Number 1 was the intended receiver on the play.
It's fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for 3. It's up, and he didn't get all of it. It falls short, and that was not this sophomore's best kick. And our score, 7-6, USC. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
Let's go! 180! 180!
Brought down right around the 32-yard line.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw. He's to the 40. He gets hit out of bounds around the 47-yard line. He's taken down at the 37.
That's a per game of 10 yards. That'll make it second in inches.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
6 yards. First down.
From the 31-yard line. First down. It's the tailback. Nice gain as he works the right side.
Game 7 on the play. That'll bring up 2nd and 3.
And now he's got room to run. And he's tackled around the 13-yard line.
Washington. First down.
Tackle made at the 10-yard line.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll make it 7-7.
Throws incomplete, knocked away.
Number 86, the intended receiver on the play.
From the 10-yard line, third down. Steps out of bounds
at about the 5-yard line.
The Trojans saw one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the action.
Washington can take the lead here with this field goal. Kicks away, and it's good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 29.
I just love to watch this defense play. They've been flying all over the field today, making big play after big play. The crazy thing is, we still have such a close game despite how well they play.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
Makes it 2nd and 2.
Quick throw to the back. It's incomplete.
Number 29.
So it's 3rd down, and they've got about 2 yards to go.
Here we go.
Caught with room to work. He's pushed out of bounds at the 42-yard line.
Gain of 21 on the play. That makes it 1st and 10.
Ready.
Passes left, gets it out to the halfback. He's knocked out of bounds at the 36.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That'll bring up 2nd and 3.
Slings it. He's tackled around the 27-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards.
18.
1st down.
I got you, son.
Caught, and he's out of bounds. That's a loss.
With the catch. That's a loss of 3 yards on the play. That brings up 2nd and 13.
2nd and 13. Ball on the 30-yard line. Quick throw, incomplete, wanted his receiver.
London, the intended receiver on the play.
This is the 8th play of this drive.
3rd and 13.
Dumps it complete over the middle. That's a great tackle at the 26.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That makes it 4th and 8.
So they're going to go for it here.
Here we go. Red 18. Red 18.
Through 3 quarters now. And still the defenses are shining. The Huskies in front by 2. Welcome back to the action. 4th quarter. This one will decide it. Tight ball game through 3.
Ready. Red 18.
Knocked out of bounds at the 18-yard line. So this game tight here in the 4th quarter. But now it's a chance for them to put this thing away. Washington is up 2. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Out in the open. And they push him out right around the 40. Down he goes at the 43. Not much on the option keeper, but it's good for a first down.
Yeah, it didn't even look like he was thinking to pitch the ball there.
He's taken down at the 44-yard line. They'll bring him down at the 41-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and seven.
From the 41-yard line, second down. Fires that quickly, incomplete.
Was the intended receiver on the play.
Here's the eighth play of the series. They'll give it off here. Nice run, and he's brought down.
Brings him down. That's a gain of 5 on the play. That'll make it 4th and 2.
It's 4th down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Washington holds just a 2-point lead. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. Takes it up the middle. He gets out to about the 32-yard line.
That brings up second and 9.
Check. Navajo! Navajo!
Get him for a loss, and that run got stuffed.
Yeah, you're right. The defense definitely won the battle at the line of scrimmage there.
Third and 12.
And this is the 12th play of the drive.
Tight right. Four down.
And then Mike 10 right here, guys. Mike 10.
Ready. Easy. Lucky.
Motion. Reset.
He zips it. Great concentration to haul it in. And he scores! Touchdown! Kirk, that was a beautiful pass and a nice catch.
Well, this is one of those plays you just sit back and admire. The quarterback threw the ball perfectly. And again, the speed of the receiver is the difference in this play.
The coverage just couldn't keep up with him there. Trying to go up by 2 scores. They line up for the extra point. And he converts the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. At the 30, he's taken down at the 32.
Well, this is a very competitive game. Just when you think one team has gained the advantage or the momentum, the other team comes fighting back, and it's going back and forth. This is almost like a basketball game.
It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, 5 wide receivers. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry, and they make the stop at the 46.
Gain of 14 yards. First down.
Let's go.
They'll spread the field with 5 wide. Got it complete, and he's out of bounds.
first and 10.
So they're going to try to determine if the receiver had possession and was inbounds or not. So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was inbounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
Well, I think the play warranted a review, but the call on the field stands. From the 32-yard line, first down. Just under 2 minutes in the game. Once and all, going deep. This one will fall incomplete. Oh, I bet the defender wishes he had that one back.
Yeah, anytime you have a chance to end a drive, especially in your own end zone, you just got to make that play.
Rifles this one out to the left, and it falls incomplete. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 22. They come out in a five-wide set. He passes it. Incomplete pass.
There was just no way anybody could catch up with that pass.
So the play of the day, fourth and ball game, and the defense comes up with the stop of the day and what will be the win. Last drive ended with as good a result as you can hope for, and I'm sure they'd like to replicate that here.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. I mean, one thing is that any defensive coordinator will tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. They give to the tailback. Tackle around the 39-yard line. USC's going to take their first time out of the half. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts.
Number 6 was the intended receiver on the play. That brings up 4th and 3.
Down at the 33-yard line. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. And he throws it away. From their own 33-yard line. Second down. Incomplete.
I'll tell you, if he put a little bit more air under that ball, that would have allowed the receiver to run right underneath it and catch it right in stride.
With a quick throw, pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. Excellent open field tackle. The Trojans call a timeout. That's their second of the half. Now it's 1st and 10 with a defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass.
Ready. Check. Snake on.
Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that.
Check. Fox two.
That makes it 2nd and 8.
Spikes the ball.
That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
They'll line up with 5 wide receivers.
Ready, go!
He heaves it to the end zone.
The pass falls incomplete. Number 6 was the intended receiver on the play. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field.
It's always a gamble going for it with so many yards to come up with. But when you're behind, sometimes you have to take risks to get back into a ball game.
The offense just wasn't able to make a play. The defense was really clutch right there. Not much luck the last time this offense had the ball. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. He takes a knee. USC will take their final timeout. And he'll just take a knee here to kill the clock. And the ball game's over. The Huskies with the victory, 16-7.
16, and the Trojans.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.